Hi, welcome back. We are solving problems as part of trigonometry, multiple and submultiple angles. This is a problem we have. We'll try to solve a couple of more problems so that we can apply the concepts and get more expertise on this topic. So this is a problem. If theta is between 450 degrees and 540 degrees and sine theta equal to 12 by 13, then what are the values of sine theta by 2 and cos theta by 2? To go ahead with the problem, first we have to understand, we have been given theta, we have to find out theta by 2 and cos theta by 2. How to find out theta by 2 and cos theta by 2 if I know theta? I know couple of formulas, let me just try to put them here. If you remember, we know that sine theta by 2 equal to square root of 1 minus cos theta by 2 and cos theta by 2 equal to square root of 1 plus cos theta by 2. But we haven't been given cos theta, we have been given sin theta. But we know sin theta, we can get cos theta. We can get them. We are aware of that because by Pythagoras, or you can use formulas. Okay. Let's first draw the triangle for theta. And where the theta is between 450 and 540, that is nothing but minus 360 if you do. This is 90 and this is 180. So it is between 90 and 180, which is nothing but which quadrant? Second quadrant. Theta is in second quadrant. In second quadrant, all sine is positive. Cos is negative. Okay. What's the value of sine? Sine is given as 12 divided by 13. By Pythagoras, we can find out that this is nothing but equal to 5. So what's the value of cos theta? We got cos theta equal to minus 5 by 13. Okay. Now once we know cos theta, it's very simple. I can directly go ahead and substitute in this formula. So I will say sine theta by 2 equal to square root of 1 minus cos theta, that is minus 5 by 13 by 2, this whole root. This is nothing but equal to 1 plus 5 by 13 by 2, that is nothing but equal to 13 plus 5, 18, 18 by 13 into 2. 9 times. So this is 9 by root 13, that is nothing but equal to 3 by root 13 or 3 by radical 13. Similarly, I can find out what is the value of cos theta by 2. We just only found the magnitude. Square root of can be plus or minus, right? We will see which value is correct value. Similarly, cos theta by 2 is 1 plus cos theta by 2, that is minus 5 by 13 by 2. That is nothing but 1 minus 5 by 13 by 2. 13 minus 5 is 8. That is 8 by 13 into 2, 4 times. Square root of 4 by 13, that is plus or minus 2 by root 13. Now we have couple of values there. Plus 3 by root 13, minus 3 by root 13. Plus 2 by root 13, minus 2 by root 13. What are the values of sine theta by 2, cos theta by 2 out of this? Now if you look at theta is between 450 and 540, where will be theta by 2? Theta by 2 is lies between 225 and 270. If theta is between 450 and 540, theta by 2 lies between 450 by 2 and 540 by 2, that is 225 by 270, which is there in the third quadrant. And you know in the third quadrant, sine and cos both are negative. So the value here will be minus 3 by 13 and the value here will be minus 2 by 13 because both sine and cos are negative in the third quadrant. So the values answer for this problem is minus 3 by 13 and minus 3 by root 13 and minus 2 by root 13. We'll do one more problem. So this is a problem. If theta lies in third quadrant and sin theta equal to minus 4 by 5, then what's the values of cosecant theta by 2 and tan theta by 2? So first let me draw this so that it's clear. Third quadrant, that means this is 180, 270, or you can call it as radians pi to 3 pi by 2, and we are there in the third quadrant. This is where the theta is, and if theta is there in 180 and 270, where theta will be? Theta by 2 will be here between 90 and 135. So this is 90, 0, 360. Theta by 2 will be in the second quadrant, and theta is there in the third quadrant. So same like we have to find out theta by 2, the only formula which is easy is to find out theta by 2 is by with the help of sin theta by 2 with the help of cos theta, that is 1 minus cos theta by 2. Now sin theta is minus 4 by 5 because we are in third quadrant. So what will be cos theta? If I draw triangle for theta and I see third quadrant, both sin and cos are, this is 5, this is minus 4, this will be minus 3 because both cos and sin both are negative in third quadrant. All sin, tan, only tan is positive. All sin, tan, cos. So only tan is positive here, only sin is positive here. So I'll just go ahead and substitute this. Square root of 1 minus cos theta is minus 3 by 5. That means it is minus 3 by 5 by 2. That is 1 plus 3 by 5 by 2. That is 5 plus 1, 3, 5 into 1, 5 plus 3, 8, 8 by 5, 8 by 10 is nothing but equal to 4 by 5. That is nothing but equal to 2 by root 5. Sin theta by 2 is root 2 by root 5. Therefore, cosecant theta by 2 is nothing but reverse of it. That is root 5 by 2. Now, what is the value of tan theta by 2? For that, we can draw the triangle of theta by 2. We can go ahead and draw the triangle of theta by 2. We are in second quadrant for theta by 2. In the second quadrant, sin is positive, cos is negative. So we know sin theta equal to 2 by root 5. That means this is 2, this is root 5. So this value is 1. So tan theta by 2 is nothing but equal to opposite by adjacent, that's nothing but equal to minus 2. So that's how we can solve these problems. Let's do one more problem. Hi, this is another problem. If cos alpha equal to 3 by 5, cos beta equal to 5 by 3, alpha beta are acute angles. Prove that sin square alpha minus beta by 2 equal to 1 by 65, cos square alpha plus beta by 2 equal to 16 by 65. Now we have been asked to find out the values in terms of submultiples. That means we have been given alpha beta, we have to find out the values of alpha minus beta by 2. Now if I take alpha minus beta as A, take this as something like B, what I see there is sin square A comma cos square B. So this I know is nothing but equal to 1 minus cos 2A by 2. Or if I take this is nothing but sin square A by 2, then I know this is nothing but equal to 1 minus cos A by 2. And cos square B by 2 is nothing but equal to 1 plus cos B by 2. I hope you are with me. What I am saying is, let's forget that there are alpha minus beta. Let us say it is A. Sin square A by 2 is nothing but equal to 1 minus cos A by 2. Why? Because cos A equal to 1 minus 2 sin square A by 2. Similarly, cos b equal to 2 cos square b minus b by 2 minus 1. So these are nothing but formulas what we have used earlier. Now only the thing is there are alpha minus beta, that means I have to find out cos of alpha minus beta, cos of alpha plus beta. What I am trying, let me just put it here so that it is clear. I am saying let a equal to alpha minus beta comma b equal to alpha plus beta. What we have to find out is sine square a, that is nothing but equal to 1 minus sine square a by 2. I have to find out alpha minus beta is a, so sine square a minus a by 2, that is nothing but equal to 1 minus cos a by 2, comma similarly cos square b by 2 is equal to 1 plus cos b by 2. Now only the thing is I have to find out what is cos a cos b. So let's go ahead and find out what is cos a cos b. Once we find out, we can directly substitute it here. There is nothing in that, right? Okay. Now what is cos a? Cos a is nothing but cos of alpha minus beta, that is equal to cos alpha cos beta plus sin alpha sin beta. Let me try to simplify that. That is nothing but equal to cos alpha cos beta. What is value of cos alpha? Cos alpha is 3 by 5. Cos beta equal to 5 by 13. Now by this time you are very clear with the triangles. So sin alpha is 4 by 5. And sin beta equal to 12 by 13. How we got them? Pythagoras. Because we know one angle, one trigonometric ratio, we can find out the remaining all. So this is nothing but equal to 3 5s are 15, 4 12s are 48. If I add them, that's nothing but equal to 63 by 65. If I go to cos b, this is nothing but equal to cos of alpha plus beta. That is nothing but same thing, but I have to subtract. Cos alpha cos beta minus sin alpha sin beta. That is nothing but equal to 3 by 5 into 5 by 13. Minus 4 by 15 into 12 by 13. If you simplify this, this is nothing but equal to minus 33 by 65. Now let's go ahead and directly find out the values because we know cos a cos b now. Let's find out what is sin square a by 2. We'll say sin square a by 2 is equal to 1 minus cos a by 2. That is equal to 1 minus of 63 by 65 divided by 2. If I simplify that, that's nothing but equal to 1 by 65. Excuse me. That's what we have to prove. Similarly, let's go ahead to the next one. Cos square b by 2 equal to 1 plus cos b by 2. That is nothing but 1 minus cos b is 33 by 65 by 2. That is simplify 16 by 65. So in this session we have done 2 to 3 problems solving multiple and submultiple angles where we have leveraged all the formulas of multiple and submultiple angles. It's very simple, the concept is very simple, only the thing is you have to practice. As you go on practicing, you will find out which formula will make it easy for you to solve the problem. Okay, see you in the next video where we will do couple of problems, then we'll wrap up multiple and submultiple angles, then we will go to sum to product and product to sum transformations. See you in the next video. Thanks for visiting. Bye for now.